it's Ayushi. Now let's have a quick look at the stories making headlines today. Mario Draghi is sworn in as Italian Prime Minister, prepares to head Italy's new unity government. Rahul Gandhi's two-day state visits end, addresses farmers in Rupanganj, PM Gehlot escorts him to the airport. On World Radio Day, Chief Minister Ashok Gehlot wishes to radio listeners, PM Gehlot also meets him. Major road accident in Surakarta of Sri Ganganagar, Lakshmi's ship, 4-9. Italy's Mario Draghi has formally accepted the role of Italy's next Prime Minister. Mr. Draghi, the ex-head of the European Central Bank, has named his cabinet after meeting the Italian president. He has secured the support of almost all the main political parties following the collapse of the previous administration last month. It was thrown into chaos amid a row over how to spend EU coronavirus recovery funds. Italy is still grappling with the pandemic and is also facing its worst economic crisis in decades. The country has recorded more than 93,000 deaths, the sixth highest death toll in the world. After receiving the support of the largest group in the parliament, the five-star movement, Mr. Draghi now has backing across the broad political spectrum. It means he will have a large enough majority to push through his agenda. As the proceedings in Lok Sabha started, Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman, while replying to the discussion on budget, said, "A challenging situation like pandemic didn't deter government from taking up reforms that are going to be necessary for sustaining long-term growth for this country." Nirmala Sitharaman said the Bharatiya Janata Party has constantly believed in India. Sitharaman said that this budget will set pace for India to become Atmanirbhar. National Security Advisor Ajit Doval, one of the most protected individuals in India, has recently faced terror threats from Jaish e Mohammed. Officials in Delhi and Srinagar said information about a detailed video recce of Doval's office was revealed during interrogation by Jaish operative Hidayat Ullah Malik, a Shofian resident who was arrested on February 6. On May 24, 2019, he took an Indigo flight from Srinagar to New Delhi to record a video of the NSA's office and passed it on through WhatsApp to his Pakistan-based handler. The handler was described simply as Doctor. A case FIR number 15-2021 under Section 18 and 20 UAP Act has been registered against Malik at the Gangyal Police Station. While Rahul Gandhi's two-day Rajasthan visit ended today, Rahul Gandhi met and addressed farmers in Rupanganj. Today was the second day of Rahul Gandhi's Rajasthan tour. After addressing Jan Sabha in Kishangarh, Rahul first paid visit to the Tezaji Temple in Kishangarh, Ajmer. Immediately after this, Rahul addressed tractor rally in Rupanganj. After Ajmer, Rahul finally addressed the Kisan Mahapanchayat rally at Makrana, Nagaur.
अब मैं कह रहा हूँ, ये जो तीन कानून बनाए जा रहे हैं, ये हिंदुस्तान के सबसे बड़े बिजनेस को हिंदुस्तान के 40% जनता से छीनने का काम किया जा रहा है और देश को नुकसान होने वाला है। और इसीलिए ये सिर्फ किसान की जिम्मेदारी नहीं है, ये सिर्फ किसान की जिम्मेदारी नहीं है, ये मजदूर की जिम्मेदारी है, ये हर युवा की जिम्मेदारी है, ये छोटे व्यापारियों की जिम्मेदारी है, ये सबकी पूरे हिंदुस्तान की जिम्मेदारी है। भाई और बहनों, ये किसी एक उद्योगपति का बिजनेस नहीं है, ये जो बिजनेस है कृषि का बिजनेस है, ये भारत माता का बिजनेस है।
A high-speed truck hits a jeep coming on NH62 in Suratgarh. Reportedly, four people died on the spot while nine were injured. A family living in village Goluwala of Piribanga Tehsil in Hanumangarh district were returning from Poonrasar Dham. The jeep carried four women, four children and seven men. The accident took place near Rajiasar at around 2 in the afternoon. The local people informed the police and took out the people trapped in the jeep. Three people died on the spot. Locals admitted the injured to nearby towns for treatment from their private vehicles. Police as well as reached on the spot and seized both the vehicles while the truck driver was found absconded. Accident at Rajiasar in Suratgarh. Accident due to truck overtake, truck bus collided. Jeep was carrying four women, four children and seven men. Three people died on the spot, four injured. Driver absconded, police seized the vehicle. The fourth day of Rajasthan's Legislative Assembly budget session was marked by Governor Kalraj Mishra's address to them. During the question hour on Saturday, the third day of the budget session in Rajasthan Legislative Assembly, the ministers appeared to be entangled in their own questions. When questions by Revenue Department were raised, Industrial Minister Prasad Lal Meena and Minister Bhavar Singh Bhati were unable to reply. On the other hand, Sayyam Loda raised questions on soaring petrol and diesel prices in the state. Meanwhile, from Monday, Chief Minister will reply to all the questions raised placed in President's address. On the occasion of World Radio Day, Chief Minister Ashok Gehlot and Prime Minister Modi wishes radio listeners a very happy day. Every year on February 13, World Radio Day is celebrated. This year is the 10th anniversary of World Radio Day. The UNESCO has called on radio stations to celebrate the 10th anniversary of World Radio Day through three sub-themes: evolution, innovation and connection. The popularity of Prime Minister Narendra Modi's Mann Ki Baat proves the importance of radio as a medium of communication. Well, there's a good news for cricket fans. India takes on England in the second test in Chennai. India kept a target of 190 runs, whereas the man of the match was Rohit Sharma. One of the best knocks from Rohit Sharma as the crowd went up on their feet. Rohit Sharma also gets applauded by the Indian team in the dressing room as he waves his bat. A brilliant knock from a class player. Well, that's a wrap with me. In case you like this video, don't forget to share, subscribe and comment. Thanks for watching.